Dear students, today we will start a topic on work study of industrial engineering and ergonomics. So its contents are productivity, work study, method study, and at last work measurement. So at first we discuss what is the productivity. So high productivity refers to doing the work in a shortest possible time with least expenditure on inputs without sacrificing quality and with minimum wastage of resources. So basically high productivity is to spend less on inputs and gain more from the output, you know, with minimum wastage of resources and without sacrificing the quality. So the quality must not be compromised for the sake of productivity. This is the basic concept. Sometimes people think that for high productivity we have to compromise for the quality, but the definition of the productivity inherently include that the quality must not be sacrificed. Quality must be maintained. Other factors which affects the production cost must be minimized, and the factors which are not affecting the production cost must be minimized to a minimum level. It is very obvious thing that it is crucial to the welfare of industrial firm as well as for the economic progress of the country, because if we gain more from less input, then it will definitely be advantage for some industrial organizations. So we have to quantify the productivity. So productivity is basically output upon input. So productivity is the quantitative relation between what we produce and what we use as a resource to produce them, that is arithmetic ratio of amount produced output to the amount of resources. Productivity can be expressed as output upon input. Productivity refers to the efficiency of the production system. It's just like analogous to the efficiency of a boiler. That the boiler, what the efficiency of the boiler is. It is the concept that guides the management of production system. It is indicator to how well the factor of production are utilized. So basically it indicates how the factors, suppose we consider 3M, man, machine and material, how they are better utilized. If these three M's, namely man, machine, material, are utilized properly and more efficiently, then we get high productivity. So for achieving high productivity, we have to limit our resources of input, or we have to minimize our input and gain a maximum of the output. So these are the factor affecting the productivity, and some factors are controllable factors which can be controlled easily, and some are the factors which are not controllable, which are not in our hand to control them. So they are like structural adjustment. If we want to do some structural adjustment, it is not an easy controlling factor that you can control within a minute or within a day. It takes time and you cannot control it. Natural resources, so you cannot control the natural resources. If it is raining outside, then you cannot control it. If there is some mountain and it is affecting your productivity, or if there is some river and it is affecting your productivity, you cannot change it. These are the natural resources and they cannot be changed so easily. And government and infrastructure, if means that it means some government policies are there which may increase your productivity or increase or decrease your production cost, then you cannot change for it cannot be changed, and it cannot be changed easily, or it cannot be in our hand, or it cannot be controllable factors. So now we discuss the controllable factors. So controllable factors are namely like material, what material we use, and the material from where we purchase. These are the our controllable factors, that we can change the material, we can choose the quality of material. So these are the some controllable factors. Human factors, work method, how the how the work can be done. So these are incomes in the control factors. Management styles, what are the management policies, that can be changed from time to time. Management can change their policies, management working style can be changed. So these are some controllable factors. So production, in production factors, in product factors, what product we have to make, how it can be made, what are the features. So these can be controlled easily. Plant and equipment technology. So plant and equipment technology means you can use a newer version of machines, or some you can use some newer technology. So these can factors which can be controlled easily and which can be done to enhance the productivity. So now we come to the topic work study. The purpose of work design is to identify the most effective means of achieving necessary function. This work study aims at improving the existing and proposed ways of doing work and establishing standard times for work performance. It means that the work study aims to, or the main objective of the work study, to improve the existing ways of doing a work. If we are doing a work in certain manner, the work study critically examined that procedure and it will modify it, then it is known as the work study. And how the work study complete its task, it consists of two techniques. First one is the method study and work measurement. As name suggests, method study relates to the some methods and procedures, and where the work measurement relates to some time measurement of the work, or relate to the measuring the time taken to complete the work. So we describe them in detail. What is method study? Method study is a systematic recording and critically examining of existing and proposed way of doing work as a means of developing and applying easier and more effective methods and reducing costs. So basically, method study is systematically recording and critically examining the methods or the ways in which the work is done. They critically they record with a camera and they analyze what the things are going wrong and what the things are going good, and how the what are the ideal time and how the method can be improved and how can the method be modified. So these are the basics of the method study. Now the work measurement. Work measurement is the application or techniques designed to establish the time for a qualified worker to carry out a specified job at a definite level of, at a defined level of performance. It means that it calculates or evaluates a time, a particular time to complete that job. Suppose if you know that how much time a work can take, or in how much time a work can be completed, you can easily calculate a work of a whole shop floor or a whole industry. Suppose, for example, a nut bolt takes 5 minutes from a raw material of a cylindrical shape of mild steel, and it can, in 5 minutes, it can be converted into a nut and bolt. It takes approximately, for example, it takes 5 minutes. Then for making 100 nut bolts, it takes around 500 minutes. This is just like a calculation of a per piece. So you can easily calculate that if you are going to make a 100 pieces, then it takes around 500 minutes. If it's less than 500 minutes, then it is well and good. But if it is taking more than 500 minutes, then there is something wrong going on, and it is degrading your productivity. So this is about what about work measurement, productivity, method study, and this is all about. And thank you for your session. Okay, thank you.